So 586 Fraternity Incorporated is a collegiate organization based on three principles of brotherhood, scholarship, and service. And all of us here are members of the Zeta chapter at the University of Houston. It's a social organization based upon with service.
Are there any other members here?
There's a couple of members. There's two right here.
I mean, there's
two over here. This old guy in the back.
These are good guys. They are also students here at University of Houston. Okay? And is there anything that I said that was not correct?
No, it's all about self-responsibility and knowledge. If you don't have, you can, everything that you do in college is like based off of your own actions and your own decisions. So it's all under your control. So it's all, you have to learn a little bit of responsibility, and then being responsible helps you succeed in life. So.
When you guys get to college, and I said when, I believe everybody in here is going to college. So when you guys get to college, your parents won't be there to help you, per se. It's gonna be totally on you. Nobody is gonna be there to wake you up in the morning, make you breakfast. So it's really like right before you become like an adult. So it's a lot, but you know, we're pretty well. We're very involved on campus. We're all really good friends. And we hold each other accountable, make sure everybody's getting our work done and everything.
Could you tell them the major? What is the major?
My major is math. Anybody like math in here? By show hands, y'all like math? Okay, cool. All right, I like math. my major is math, and what a major is it's kind of like a specialty. So you go into college, and you have a specialty, and you take certain classes that pertain to that. So I'm a math major, so of course I'm taking a lot of math classes. He's a political science major, and that's like the government and all that stuff. So he's taking a lot of classes about that. And when you get to college, there's a major, that's like your special, and then there's a minor too. And that's just...
Well, minor is almost like just another thing you're interested in where you want to learn more and make that a secondary option for you can either fall back on or just if you want to continue your education or something. If you suppose you like math, you're like, oh, I kind of like English a little bit too, even though I didn't agree with that thing. So I don't know what I'm talking about. You say, oh, let me be an English minor so I can like further my education and then just kind of be more well rounded and broaden your horizon.
The thing is, like, when you get to college, you kind of get to choose what you want to learn. It's not like when you're younger and you're like put in certain classes. So when you get to college, you get to choose your classes for the most part. So most of the time, your first 2 years, you take a lot of broad classes, and after that, it's like only what you want. So if anyone only likes science here, or if anyone like really likes animals, you can only study, like for the most part, you will only study animals and learn a lot about animals and all that stuff. And so that would be your major. Your main interest would be your major. And then if you have another interest, like if you really like learning about dinosaurs, but then you really like football at the same time, you could major in something that you learn. You study about animals, you study about the history of animals, you study about dinosaurs, like paleontology type
thing.
So you can minor in like running the football team, running the like the administration part of sports or the very part of sports. So that's, you get to like vote, you major minor in what you want to learn. It's not people telling you what to do. So it goes back to like the responsibility again. So you pick what you want to learn, so it makes you more interesting, and that's why it's easier to do harder work than what you want to learn about.
Any questions?
finish up there? Social studies?
Yes.
What's yours?
Science.
Yes.
If you need anything, you don't need it. You
can use the best of both rules.
Thank you.
Okay, so we got a lot of all over the place. That's okay. It's like, that's okay. But when you guys get to college, you really get to he said, you really get to learn what you want to learn. So if you like math or you like science, you'll only be taking like math and science classes. So
what is college like?
Can you guys explain the process of going to college? I know we're talking about it, about all the fun things, but can anybody say, hey, I want to go to college? Isn't there a process? Can you wake up one day and say, hey, I want to go to college? What's the process? Can you explain that process for me?
Yeah.
That's what I'm looking for. Acceptance. You have to be accepted into the university. That means you have to do the things you just said. Write the essays and make the grades. Okay? That's the most important thing. I want to go to college, making the grades, and getting acceptance. The acceptance letter is the most important thing, guys.
Because the schools, they don't have to accept you. If you guys know about Harvard, that's one of the most prestigious, one of the most well-known schools in the United States. It's really hard to get in there, and a lot of people don't get in. It's only the people with the top grades. So whatever you do in high school, in middle school, elementary school, whatever you do growing up, the higher your chance to get in. So I want everyone to aspire to go to college. So if you do aspire to college, just study your books. First of all, it's not going to be easier. It's going to be harder to get, but at the same time, when you do,
everything like that. So the more you study now, the easier it's going to be.
How many of you guys like homework? Any of y'all like homework?
No.
College is pure homework. Everything you do will be at home. So I know your teachers probably tell you, I know everybody here probably tell you, you know, do good in school, but once you get to college, I mean, they're not gonna be, you know, they're gonna coach you in the classroom, but once you get home, it's gonna be your job to do all of your homework, all study for your tests. So I just wanna stress to y'all, definitely do your homework, because a lot of that is gonna teach you, you know, good practices. So when you get to college, you will have that already set, that you will be in that mindset to do work at home.
And the teachers don't give you homework just to be mean. Teachers are giving you homework to reinforce what you learned in class, to help you move forward to the next grade. So don't look at it as like a punishment, like, oh, you know, I gotta do homework. It's really to help you guys. So, of course it's great, but make sure you guys are doing your homework too.